What's up, Motion? How are you guys today?
What's up, everybody?
Gary, are you so excited to get into what we're talking about with all of our friends today as we learn about God and gratitude?
I am so pumped. You have no idea.
I'm literally so excited. But first, we need to greet our VIPs. What's up? If you are new here, that means you are a very important person, which means you're a VIP. So make sure you stick around later, and we're going to tell you something special that you get to take home with you.
Ooh, fun.
Super, super fun. Okay, guys, but remember, I told you we're learning about gratitude, as we know, but this week we are specifically learning about, Jerry, do you want to tell them?
Yes, we are learning how to make a habit of being grateful.
I know, it's so important to make a habit. Jerry, did you know that I heard that if you do something like for 30 days in a row, then it becomes a habit? Is that right?
Yes. Yeah, I think so. So like for me, so all this month, you know, that now that I've been digital, yeah. Every single day I've been trying to hack into bank servers to try to give myself unlimited money.
No, Jerry, no.
So it's becoming a habit of mine to try to get rich.
No, I don't think so. I don't think that's what we're talking about at all. You don't need to be hacking anything.
You don't know how I grind, Elizabeth.
No, that's not the vibes. No.
This is my hustle.
Jerry, no. If you want money, you need to get a job.
You got
to
change your grind set.
No. Your grind set. Okay, listen, that is not at all what we're talking about. We are talking about being grateful, like being grateful for God, for all he's done for you, for your family, for friends, maybe for your pets, for your house, all that kind of stuff. Super, super fun. And we can be grateful for other things too, even just like having a really great day and all that kind of stuff. So, and since we're learning that we can make a habit of being grateful, I'm going to go ahead and get into some thank you notes.
Oh, wait. I was going to do a drum roll.
Okay, I think it's kind of after the fact now, but that's fine.
Yeah, the reveal has already been done.
Yeah, it's fine though. All right, here we go. Let's make some thank you notes. Thank you, hot dogs, for not having an actual dog inside the bun.
Yeah, I tried. Believe me, they get really upset.
No, Jerry. No. Okay, we're just going to move past that. Moving past that. Okay, here we go. Thank you, Chris, for the way you serve in Motion at Elevation Matthews. The peace and joy you bring to your group is so special. Shout out to Chris, honestly. That's awesome. Okay, here we go. Another one. Thank you, Candy Apples, for letting me eat candy and fruit at the same time.
Whoop, whoop, shout out.
I love that. Okay, Jerry, do you want to do one?
Sure. Thank you, Raven and Renee, for leading a Motion group together at Elevation Toronto East. The way you make sure everyone has fun while they learn about Jesus is so appreciated.
Wow, Jerry, that was a really, really long note. They must be awesome.
They're good volunteers.
Okay, everybody, we just showed that we are grateful for our leaders and also some other stuff like candied apples and, you know, hot dogs not having an actual dog in them, which is great. We are going to go ahead and stand up on our feet as we worship and show how we are grateful to God. Okay, everybody, go ahead, stand up on your feet. And Jerry, are you ready to worship too?
Let's do it.
Let's do it.
lost without a reason for the pain. But then you stepped right in and showed me grace. You found me, you found me. I can't get enough of you. You got my heart with everything you do. Now your love's making me new. You're the one I'm running to. Forever you're my reason. Gave my life a meaning. Got me singing through the night. High up and with love is. I won't stop for nothing. Got me dancing through the trial. To the rhythm of your heartbeat. 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 Heart to
job worshiping, everybody. Go ahead and have a seat. Go ahead and sit down. Okay, guys, so today, remember, we're learning about gratitude and showing how we can be grateful for something. And one of the things I am super grateful for is Sunday, which is also the day where we celebrate Sabbath.
Oh, what's Sabbath?
Okay, well, the cool thing is it's a very special word that means rest. And it's important because Sabbath is something God wants us to do. And he even did it himself when he created everything. So remember, he made everything in like 6 days. And then on the seventh day, he rested. And that shows us that it's important to rest and spend time with God. And that's a lot of times what we do on Sunday. Yeah, it's when we celebrate Sabbath. So something else I'm grateful for is how generous our church is. And there are lots of ways to be generous. Jerry, what are some ways to be generous? What do you think?
Well, you can help people out. You can do chores for them. You can help clean up houses. You can take them meals. You can help them break out of a closet when you accidentally lock them in there.
Oh, no, we don't want to do that. Yeah,
okay,
no,
but
no.
All the other things, right?
All the other things are good, yeah. And I think we should learn more about what it means to be generous. So let's go ahead and check out this video. Okay, everybody, we are here at the Matthews Outreach headquarters. We are about to make some hygiene kits. What? Are you so excited, Alika?
I'm super stoked.
I'm super excited too. Guys, part of our learning this month is about generosity. And one way that we can give to people is by creating some hygiene kits that have like toothbrushes and combs and some shampoo. What else we got here, Alika?
Lotion.
Yeah.
We got deodorant.
Yeah, awesome. All this
toothpaste,
stuff. We
right?
love it.
All the stuff.
It's very important because some parts of the world, people may not have access to like showers and stuff like that. So we want to be able to give of what we have here and what we've been blessed with and share it. And also sometimes there may be like a crisis or something like that where people may need a little extra. So then we're ready to be able to help give because remember, generosity is
all things giving, right? God loves a cheerful giver, and that doesn't mean just your money, right?
Exactly.
It means your time and maybe packing some kits or your resources.
Yeah.
And what I love about when he says to give, it talks about being cheerful.
Yes.
Like being happy and joyful about giving is
we
so
love
awesome.
It. Yes.
You know?
So let's do that right now. Let's get into
let's
it. Come
it.
On.
Cool.
Wow, guys, that was so much fun. Alika, did you have a great time?
I had an awesome time.
Me too. I really love being a cheerful giver. So guys, remember, we aren't just learning about generosity, we're also learning about gratitude. So yes, one way that we can be generous with our gratitude is by thanking all the people in our lives. And remember, you don't just have to be generous with your money, you can also be generous with your time and your resources.
Yes.
So yeah, I had a great time, Alika, didn't you?
Yes, I did.
So
see
fun.
Y'all.
Bye. Wow, guys, I love that we're learning that gratitude is another way that we can be generous. For example, we can be generous with how grateful we are by saying thank you to people and doing things for them. And it's much easier to be a cheerful giver when we have a grateful heart. So Story Lab is up next, right? And it's going to talk about how we always have something to be grateful for.
Happy birthday. H-A-P-Y? What kind of spelling is that? Oh, hey, welcome to Story Lab. This week we're talking about gratitude while we take a look at a super helpful habit. Ha! Shout out to whoever invented the eraser.
Hey, I'm Carter.
And I'm Zeke.
We're talking about gratitude,
which is letting others know you see how they've helped you.
Who's the card for?
My big sister. She's basically the best sister in the world.
You got any scientific evidence for that?
Well, she helped me learn to ride a bike. Plus, she always checked my closet for monsters.
I like to eat socks.
And when I couldn't understand fractions, she made it all easy. This is 1/6 of a pizza. See? Best sister in the world.
Okay, that's pretty convincing evidence. Are you doing anything for her birthday?
Now, see, that's the problem.
What's the problem?
Well, she loves cinnamon rolls, so every year for her birthday breakfast, I get her these awesome, gooey cinnamon rolls.
No problem there.
But this year she went gluten-free, and I can't find any gluten-free cinnamon rolls anywhere.
Well, why don't you make them?
Because I'm not a pastry chef.
I know how you can learn in 5 minutes.
5 minutes? For reals?
For reals.
Then, let's make it! Okay, where do we start?
1 tablespoon of oil.
What are we mixing it in?
This.
Cinnamon rolls in a mug?
Gluten-free cinnamon roll, microwavable mug cake, to be exact.
Genius!
There we go.
Okay, what next?
2 tablespoons of sugar. Add 1 egg yolk.
Wait, how do you put in just the egg yolk?
Like this. Use your hand like a sieve. So as you can see, the egg yolk is splitting from the egg white. And then when you have nothing but the yolk, put it in the mug.
Looks delicious.
Now, you mix that up with a fork while I go wash my hands.
Please.
All right, great. Then we add 2 tablespoons of milk. Like that. And then a 1/4 cup of all-purpose gluten-free flour. Zeke, would you be so kind?
Of course.
You can also just use regular flour if you don't need it to be gluten-free. Then a 1/8 teaspoon baking powder. And 1/2 teaspoon of cinnamon. Now, mix it all up. Gently.
Wow, that's it?
Well, we still gotta make some ooey gooey frosting. But right now, it's time for
the story before the story.
Today, we're in the book of Exodus and the book of 1 Corinthians.
In the beginning, God created an amazing world, but people forgot God and turned away. The world was broken.
God chose one family, the Israelites, and promised to bless the entire world through them.
But God's people were enslaved in the land of Egypt for hundreds of years. The people cried out to God, and God saved them.
But it's so easy to forget the amazing things God has done. So God told the people to hold a celebration. Each year, they would eat a special meal to help them remember how God saved them.
And though the Israelites did forget again and again, they still came back to that special meal.
Which is where our story starts.
Take it away.
Hey, everyone. I'm Brian. More than 1,000 years after God led the people out of Egypt, Jewish people were still celebrating that special meal, the Passover. In fact, the night before Jesus gave up his life, he ate the Passover meal with his closest friends.
Take this and eat it.
Now, each time the Jewish people ate the Passover meal, it reminded them of how hard they had been forced to work in Egypt. Then, God sent Moses to face down Pharaoh and demand freedom for the Israelites.
Let my people go.
Over and over, Pharaoh promised to let the Israelites go, but then changed his mind. And each time, God sent a plague, a terrible warning, so Pharaoh would release the Israelites. There were frogs, flies, hail, darkness, and more. Finally, God sent the 10th and most terrible plague of all.
The Lord says, every oldest son in Egypt will die.
It was a terrible day, but God made a way to save the sons of the Israelites.
Go at once. Each family must kill a Passover lamb. Put some of the blood on top and on both sides of the door frame. The Lord won't let the destroying angel enter your homes.
The Israelites did just as God had told them. After a heartbreaking night, the Israelites were saved. At last, Pharaoh ordered them to leave.
Get out of here. Go!
The Israelites packed up so quickly they didn't even have time for their bread to rise, so they baked flat bread without yeast.
Crunchy.
Then, God led them out of Egypt to freedom. God told the people, always remember this day. You and your children after you must celebrate this day as a feast to honor the Lord. So as God instructed, the Israelites made a habit of celebrating Passover with a meal that included lamb and flatbread with no yeast, like the bread they'd taken on their journey out of Egypt.
Blessed are you, Lord our God, King of the universe.
Jesus himself grew up celebrating the Passover every single year. But when he shared the Passover with his friends the night before he died, Jesus did something different. He gave a brand new meaning to the Passover meal. The Apostle Paul wrote about that evening years later in his letter to the Corinthians.
On the night the Lord Jesus was handed over to his enemies, he took bread. When he had given thanks, he broke it. He said, "This is my body. It is given for you. Every time you eat it, do it in memory of me."
The bread was a reminder of how, the very next day, Jesus would give himself up and allow himself to be killed for us. Paul continued,
"In the same way, after supper, he took the cup. He said, 'This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Every time you drink it, do it in memory of me.'"
The drink was a reminder of how Jesus would allow his own blood to be spilled so that we can live. And because of Jesus, we don't have to try to prove to God that we're good enough. All we have to do is believe that Jesus came to rescue us and choose to follow him. Jesus took that old habit of gratitude, the Passover, and turned it into a brand new habit of gratitude, the Lord's Supper or communion. The Passover meal was a celebration of how God had rescued the Israelites from slavery. Now, the Lord's Supper is a celebration of how God has made it possible for everyone to be rescued from sin and death through the life and death and resurrection of Jesus. And for the last 2,000 years, people have been celebrating what Jesus did for us by eating bread and drinking wine or juice together. Some churches do it every Sunday or every month. Others might do it a few times a year. They use different kinds of bread or wafers or wine or juice. But in every case, the habit is the same. It's a beautiful chance to remember together the amazing way that God has rescued us and how God has given us so much. We can always be thankful. The end.
You know, it's super easy to think all these Bible stories are kind of random, but no way.
It's all connected in such an incredible way.
First, God made a plan to save one family, the Israelites.
And from that family, God made a plan to save everyone who follows Jesus.
Yeah, and God gave us a special way to remember.
So what's our part in the story?
Well, just like the Israelites, we can form habits of gratitude. One of the easiest ways to start is with mealtime.
Yeah, when we thank God for our food.
Now, your family might already have that habit. If not, you could start it. And you can always take a few moments and thank God for your food, even if you're eating on your own or at school.
It doesn't even have to be out loud.
You can connect habits of gratitude to other parts of the day, too.
Like when you wake up, you can thank God for a brand new day.
Even if you're not a morning person.
You could also make a habit of thanking your teacher anytime they help you at school.
Or your parents when they help you at home.
And at night, before you go to bed, take time to think back through your day.
You can choose one specific thing to thank God for, like how good it felt to hit that ball super hard, or if your mom made your favorite dinner.
Or just the amazing fact that your heart is beating and your lungs are taking in air, all because God makes it happen.
So, we can make a habit of thanking God in the morning, at mealtime, at school, and at bedtime.
Yeah, and the awesome thing about habits is that they actually rewire your brain. So if you start with one time and focus on being thankful every day, in about 3 weeks, your brain will remind you automatically.
I'm thankful God made our brains so awesome.
You got it. Thank you, thank you, and thank you. See you next time.
So, here's the thing. Make a habit of being grateful.
I am grateful in advance for this delectable mug cake. Can we zap it yet?
Sure thing.
Ooh, it's done. Frosting, please. Yeah, right in there.
That's perfect.
Right there?
Okay.
It's glorious.
Thanks for joining us in the Story Lab. See you next time.
Yum. It's so delicious. I'm definitely making the habit of this for my sister's birthday.
Oh yeah, she's gonna love this.
Let's learn more about this at group time with our friend Alika.
What's up, Motion? It's time for group time. And this week, we're talking about the habit of being grateful. How many times are you grateful in your day, or your week, or your month, or your year, or just in general? Today we're going through the Bible story called Remember Me, and it's about the Lord's Supper and Passover. And it's in 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verses 23 through 26, as well as Exodus chapter 12. Now, before we go into that, let's review our memory verse for November. You guys ready? It's Psalms 136 verse 1, and it states, "Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love endures forever." Psalms 136 verse 1. Awesome job. Now remember, we're talking about a habit of showing gratitude, a habit of being grateful. Who have you thanked or who have you been grateful for today? So when I think about habits, habits are things that I do every single day, whether I think about it or not. So for me, that's like waking up and making my bed, brushing my teeth, taking a shower, right? These are all habits in my day. So for you guys, are there some things in your day that you do all the time too, like me? Maybe some habits as well. What are some things that you do every day? Things we do every day or at regular times are called habits. What are some things you do every day that can be a reminder to stop and show gratitude to God and others? Let's read 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 26. And it states, "For whenever you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he does." Jesus gave us the habit of the Lord's Supper as a way for us to make a habit of being grateful for everything he did. What is a way you can make a habit of being thankful for Jesus? Who are some people in your life you can get into a better habit of thanking? What are some good things you think can come from the habit of being grateful? All right, friends, that's it. Let us pray. God, we want to be known as people who are grateful for the things you and others have done for us. Help us to make habits this week to show our gratitude, Father. We pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Bye. Hey, Motion. It's our last memory verse challenge for Psalms 136, verse 1. I hope you've been working on memorizing it. Let's see if we can say it together right now. Ready? Let's do it.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love endures forever.
Me and Sydney kind of have a song going on here.
Yeah.
So Sydney's actually going to show us how to find the verse in our Bible like we have been all this month.
All right. We are going to start in our trusty table of contents again at the front of the Bible. Psalm is in the Old Testament right down here for me. And it's in my Bible. It's page 493. So we're going to go there. 493. This is the closest I've been to it on the first try. All right, here we go. We're in Psalm. Now we need to find Psalm 136, verse 1. So I'm gonna look for the big 136. Where is it at? Somewhere. I'm getting close. Oh, here we go.
Too far.
All right, I found it. It says, "Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love endures forever."
Perfect. Now Cindy's gonna give us our last challenge to make sure we've all got it before we start learning a new verse next week.
Okay, so first open up your YouVersion Bible app and find Psalms 136, verse 1.
Got it. Motion, you'll need an adult in your house to help you with this part. After we're done today, go find your mom, your dad, or someone who takes care of you and ask them to look up Psalms 136, verse 1 in the YouVersion Bible app. If they don't have it, ask them to download it. It's free.
All right, here's what we're gonna do for our challenge. You're gonna work on saying the verse together, but you'll each say every other word. So if I start and I say the first word, you'll say the second word, and then I'll say the third word, and we'll keep going until we finish it. And if we get stuck, we have the verse pulled up on our phone.
Gotcha. Okay, so is the goal to work together to say the verse as fast as we can?
Exactly. Let's try it.
Give
thanks
to
the
Lord,
for
he
is
good,
and no,
his love
endures
forever. Okay, let's do it again.
That was hard. Okay.
Give
thanks
to
the
Lord,
for
he
is
good,
and his
love
endures
forever. Awesome. That's a great challenge. Honestly, it's actually pretty challenging too.
Yes.
Motion, make sure to give this a try with an adult once our time is up today, okay? This verse really helps us remember to show gratitude, so don't forget to memorize it. We'll see you back here next week for a new challenge and a new verse. Bye.
Bye. It's game time, and all this month we're gonna be playing Heads Up. I got my friends with me and we're so excited. Make sure while we're playing, you cheer for the team that you wanna win. Are you ready? Let's go.
Showtime.
Okay. On my forehead, locked in.
It's a game.
It's a game?
On the Wii!
We follow the people on the screen and you.
Dance.
Yes.
Oh, he's an Avenger, the first one.
Superman.
Captain America.
The first movie. I'm so sorry.
I mean, he can fly. Yes.
Iron Man.
It's an animal, yes. Small.
Bunny. Yes.
Rabbit.
Yes.
Who's
cleaning
the floor?
Yeah.
Vacuum.
Yes. He's
the Elizabeth
Hattie.
He's a French mouse.
Mickey Mouse.
No.
He's French. He needs the food in Paris.
Oh, a Ratatouille. Yay.
Ice cream.
Good. Oh, wow.
Oh,
like,
it's
a movie.
With a small child.
And it has to do with a small child being in charge. He's in charge.
Incredibles. Dash. Boss Baby.
Yeah.
Oh, I hate him.
What?
It's a game. Oh,
baseball. Yes. Baseball. Okay.
But he lives in a
tree?
No.
No.
A house?
Yeah. No, not. Okay. You have to cut it.
It's,
in the sky, it's witchcraft.
It's
animal in the water.
Octopus.
Yeah. He's green.
Puppets.
Oh, Kermit.
Yeah. Okay.
Oh. There's a sewer. There are.
Also,
Turtles, Ninja Turtles?
It's a Frosty the...
You make it outside of the winter.
Frosty the Snowman.
Yes!
The slime!
Oh, it gets twice of words! Okay.
Happy feet! Good time. Let's go. Okay.
Yeah.
I need my tea and crumpets. Hello?
Yes. Hello. Oh, it's a bird.
It's blue. Flamingo.
Yes.
Yeah.
It's a movie.
She's gorgeous. He's ugly.
Yeah.
She's gorgeous.
Notre Dame?
No.
Belle.
No.
Beauty and the Beast?
Yes.
Little cars. We're going to race them. Little cars.
Hot Wheels?
Yes.
Oh, you put this on when you don't want to get bit.
Yeah.
Bug spray.
Yes.
She lives in the ocean. What's her name?
Little Mermaid.
Yes.
There we go. They're fire-breathing creatures.
Yeah.
Dragons.
Yes.
God, you're too good.
Oh, it's a movie where they go in a closet.
It's red. It's a planet.
Mars. Yes. It's not. It's
they
not
have a shell.
A slug.
They have a shell.
It's not a slug, but it's a snail.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh. I love that says cheese, pepperoni on it.
Pizza.
Yes. Ninja.
Ninja.
Turtle.
Yes.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
What?
Hey, Motion. How'd you do? Did your team win? We'll have a chance to play a new game next week. See you then. Bye.
Motion, I have had so much fun with you today. I am so grateful that we got to learn about gratitude with each other today. Get it? Okay, guys, now it's time for some instruction for our new timers, our VIPs, our very important people, if you will. Listen up. Okay, everybody, tell an adult in your house that there's a link below this video. When they click on it, they'll be able to send us some information so I can reach out to you and say, hey! Okay, guys, now we're gonna pray. So let's go ahead and show God respect by bowing our heads and closing our eyes and thanking him for all he's done for us. Here we go. Jesus, thank you so much for all you've done for us. Help us to remember that we can make a habit out of being grateful. In your name we pray, everyone said, amen. Great job, guys. Wow, this has been such a fun month learning about gratitude. I cannot wait until what we learn about next week. So make sure to come back because we're going to go ahead and start on a brand new lesson together. I'm so excited. See you next week.
Rubber baby buggy bumpers. Rubber baby buggy bumpers. She sells seashells by the seashore. She sells seashells by the seashore. Okay. Gratitude. No. Gratitude. 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 Gratitude.
What are you doing, John?
Gratitude.
Why are you doing that?
Do you accept it?
Do
Do I accept what?
My deepest gratitude.
Wait, I think I can go deeper.
I'm Brandon, that's John, and we are excited and thankful for today's show.
That's right. Brandon and I just celebrated a little holiday where there was a ton of food to be thankful for.
And there were some relatives of ours who are really good at cooking that food to be thankful for.
But now there's a large supply of leftover food on hand, so it's time to play a little game we like to call Name That Leftover Great Aunt Edition. As you can see, there are three leftover dishes of deliciousness before us. Each one of these is made by one of our great aunts. Mm.
Our job is to use three of our senses, touch, taste, and smell, to try and figure out what we're eating and who made it. Mm-hmm. You ready to play?
Yeah, I'm starving, so yes.
All right. It smells kind of oniony.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Mm. Kind of gooey. Ooh, kind of runny.
Mm-hmm.
Squishy.
All right, you ready to try it?
No time like the present.
All right, bon appetit.
All right.
Oh.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. I know what this is.
And I know who made it.
Yep.
It's Aunt Margaret's
green bean casserole.
I knew
yes!
It.
Yes!
This is a holiday classic.
And a potluck staple. You know what I appreciate about Aunt Margaret?
What's that?
Even though she's your aunt and not mine, she still drops a dish of this by every year for me.
Oh, and she also, you know what? She deep fries these onions on top herself.
Yeah, which is the only way to eat an onion.
And for that we say, thank you, Aunt Margaret.
Next dish. This one already has a distinct smell.
It's definitely meaty.
Mm-hmm. Oh. That was not what I was expecting. It feels a little bready.
Yeah. What's that on top? Is that icing?
What is this, a meat cake?
One way to find out.
Yeah.
Down the hatch.
We were close with meat cake.
Yeah. Isn't this your
Aunt Linda's meatloaf?
Oh!
Yep.
Now, to be fair, everyone loves her meatloaf. It's just not my favorite.
Or mine. And she knows we're not big fans, but she continues to bring it.
Yeah.
And she even tries different ways of cooking it, you know, to see if we might change our minds.
Yeah, do you remember the habanero version?
Oh. But the fact that she keeps trying makes us say, Thank you, Aunt Linda.
Okay, last one. Mm, that's not going down.
Oh, my.
Yeah. Are you getting anything from this?
I don't think so.
Hmm.
Ooh, it's cold.
Oh, is it really?
Yeah.
Okay, well, let's find out.
All right.
Ew, ooh. Squishy.
Yeah, it's kind of wiggly like Jell-O.
I think there's more to it than that.
Uh-huh.
Shall we?
Yeah, let's go for it. All right.
What is in my mouth?
What? This is delicious.
Oh, I know what this is.
Mm.
And so do you.
Oh,
this is Aunt Riri's lime congealed salad.
Oh, yeah.
This is my Aunt Riri's signature dish,
mm-hmm.
A lime congealed salad. I'm not sure why it's called a salad.
Oh.
It's made with Jell-O, pineapple, cottage cheese.
Cottage cheese, really?
Walnuts. Oh, and I almost forgot, mayonnaise. And even though those ingredients should never go together, she believes they should. So for that unwavering conviction, we say, thank you, Aunt Riri.
I do not like mayonnaise.
Not my favorite either. It doesn't seem to bother you much.
Nope.
All right, it's Bible story time!
Hey guys, I gotta say, you two have already been riding that gratitude train today.
We have? I thought we were just eating leftovers.
You have, but you've also been extremely grateful to your aunts. You let them and everyone know how much they mean to you and how thankful you are for what they made you. And I bet you can't eat any of that food without thinking of them.
Of course not.
Remembering to be grateful is exactly what today's Bible story is all about. And I'm gonna tell it with the help of Laundry Theater. Today's story comes from two books in the Bible. One is Exodus, and one is 1 Corinthians, which is a letter Paul wrote to the church in Corinth. But let's start in Exodus. Exodus tells the story of the people of Israel, who were enslaved in Egypt and served the Egyptian king, Pharaoh. But God didn't leave them that way. He sent Moses to demand their release from Pharaoh. But Pharaoh didn't listen, not at first. So God turned Egypt's water into blood and sent plagues of frogs, insects, and disease. Nothing God did changed Pharaoh's mind. So God sent the most terrible plague of all. The oldest son of every family in Egypt would die. But God made a way to save the sons of the Israelites. Every family would sacrifice a lamb and put some of its blood over the doorframe. So when death came, it passed over the household, leaving the son alive. Finally, Pharaoh allowed the Israelites to leave. They were free. God told them to remember that day and how they were protected from death and delivered from slavery. So every year, the Israelites would celebrate that event with a feast. You may have heard of it. It's called the Passover Feast. In Jesus' time, God's people had been celebrating Passover for hundreds of years. The night before Jesus died, he gathered with his friends, his disciples, to celebrate Passover with all of its traditions. They met together in an upper room to enjoy this very special meal. The Apostle Paul describes this particular Passover meal in his letter to the Corinthians. Jesus took some bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it. Then he said, "This is my body. It is given for you. Every time you eat it, do it in memory of me." In the same way, after supper, Jesus took a cup. Jesus said, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Every time you drink it, do it in memory of me." The disciples weren't sure what was going on. They didn't understand what Jesus was about to do. They had all grown up celebrating this meal to remember and to thank God for rescuing their ancestors from slavery. Now, Jesus was giving them something new to remember. Jesus would go on to give up his life on the cross to pay for all of the sins we have done and will ever do. So this meal would be more than just a thank you to God for rescuing the Israelites from Egypt. It would be a thank you for rescuing the whole world. And this tradition of showing gratitude is still celebrated today. Maybe your family or church call it communion.
Or the Lord's Supper.
Or the Eucharist. Mm-hmm.
But whatever you call it, this demonstration of appreciation is a wonderful way to say thank you to Jesus for what he did for all of us. And by the way, gratitude is something you have to work on. You have to create a habit of showing gratitude, because if you don't, there's a good chance you'll forget. That's why you guys playing the game and telling your aunts thank you for making your food is amazing. You're creating a habit.
Well, I thought we were just playing a goofy game, but you're right. We really do appreciate them and everything they do for us. Mm-hmm.
Which is probably why they keep doing it. People love to be appreciated, and sometimes we forget that.
Hey, well, thanks for reminding us.
Hey, that's what I'm here for. See you next time.
You know, I knew we planned that game for a reason.
Yep, you said you were hungry.
Yeah. Mm. Reveal the question.
What are some good habits you have?
Brushing my teeth, flossing, you gotta floss.
Yeah, I try to exercise a few times a week, mm-hmm. even when I don't really feel like it.
Oh, when I say the blessing at dinner, I always try to make it a habit to thank God for the food. Mm,
that's a great one. What about you? What are some good habits you have?
Talk about it together.
And we'll see you next time on the So-and-So Show.
Mm-hmm. Oh boy.
Are you flossing right now?
I gotta floss.
Yeah. You do it differently than I do.
Yeah, this is exactly how you floss.
All right, John is gonna do the floss while he flosses.
Uh-huh. Wow.
Make this a habit.
Every day.
Every day.
All right. All right. Now, these are the dishes our uncles made.
Okay, great.
Right, here we go. I think I smell a barbecue.
It's pasta.
Oh, you think? Are you touching it?
I'm jumping ahead.
Yeah, that is pasta.
I know what this is. It's mac and cheese.
Is it?
Yeah.
I smell a spice, some kind of herb.
I smell gluten. All right, let's touch. What is this?
I don't know. Okay, wait.
Ooh. That's not Jello.
Oh, maybe it's cranberry sauce.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking. Good call. Cranberry sauce.
Hmm.
Oh, I know what that is.
Yeah.
Like, I got the olfactory senses of a badger. Mm. That's not watermelon.
No? Yeah, it is. Mine tastes just like watermelon.
Tastes like an aloe plant.
Interesting.
All right.
Are you eating
this? Wow. Hard. Is this celery?
It's watermelon. Did you get the same thing I did?
Yeah.
Ugh.
I don't like it, the feeling of this.
Did you try it yet?
No.
It's potato salad.
Oh, it's Uncle, let's say it together.
Uncle Bradford.
Uncle Bradford. Yep, Uncle Bendiford's
potato salad.
Yep. Mm-hmm. You know who this is.
That's right.
Uncle Kara loves
mashed potatoes.
Uncle Kara loves mashed potatoes.